I praise and thank God for this beautiful new day that the Lord has given us. Each day, the Lord has been leading and guiding each one of us. How blessed we are that we can start each day thanking the Lord, praising Him, asking wisdom and guidance for this day. We don't have to worry about anything because we have a Father. For today's meditation, let's turn to Proverbs chapter 30, verse 27. Proverbs 30, verse 27. The locusts have no king, yet they go forth, all of them by bands. Again, I'll read. The locusts have no king, yet go they forth, all of them by bands. Previous days, we have been looking at these small creatures. How, though they are small in size, but the Creator has blessed them with wisdom. How they go about their daily affairs. This morning, let's look at these locusts. They have no kings, no one to lead, no one to tell them what they are supposed to do. But we see when they come in thousands, hundred thousands. They come and they destroy the whole fields. How can they do so much destruction without having no one to tell them or to guide them? How is it possible? From that, we can understand that how each locust, he understands his responsibility. He works as a team member. Together as a team, they go about their work. And then you see the destruction they do. If they had a leader, they would have never done so much destruction. There's a lesson for us as children of God. We are supposed to not live for ourselves anymore. We need to have that attitude. When we are dead with Christ, it is Christ who has to live in and through us. The Lord has blessed us with one more day. Am I going to live this day just for myself? Just for my family? Or am I desiring? Or am I yearning? Or will I be making sure that today I'll be not living for myself, but I want my life to be a blessing for others? That's the true Christian spirit. We live for others, so that others may be blessed through our life. We are not interested in our own blessings. The Lord has blessed us more than that, more than what we want. Our desire is that others should be blessed by us. Look at these locusts. They have their instinct. The Creator has put that instinct in them. No one has to tell them. And they go about their affairs. Look at us. The Lord has put a conscience inside us. The Spirit of God is there with us. We have the Word. We have the new creation inside us. Are we not supposed to be more mature? Even if there is no one to tell me what I'm supposed to do, am I not aware of my high calling, my responsibility? The Lord is watching over us. How I am conducting myself. Is my life a blessing for others? So as we face this new day, look at this locust. No kings, no one to tell them. They just obey their instinct, and as a team they work, each one doing his part as children of God. May the Lord help us, give us that wisdom, so that we realize our responsibility. As we start this new day, may the Lord help us. The coming of the Lord is so near. You can just imagine, once the church is gone, what will be the condition of this world? Once the salt departs, you and I, we are the salt. Let us not live for ourselves, but let us live for Christ, And may the Lord help us to be a blessing for others. So many people will touch our lives this day, and we pray that they all see the glory of God. Let's close our eyes and go ahead. Father, we praise you and thank you for this beautiful opportunity that you have given us as we are in your presence. Thank you for teaching us through these locusts, small creatures, but the wisdom that you have given and how they go about. The life is so brief. Lord, thank you for speaking to us. We have a big responsibility towards this society. Lord, those who see us may see you. Let us not live for ourselves, for our self-interest. We are part of your body, the church. Help us to realize our responsibility, our high calling, and work together so that others are blessed. Thank you for your Spirit that's there to lead and to guide. May your name be glorified this day. We give you all glory and honor. In Jesus' most holy name we pray. Amen. We pray that this day is a blessing for each and every one of us. May the Lord's will be fulfilled in and through us. Maranatha.